Hello and welcome to Planetary Imaging and Processing Part 3. My name is Doug Hubble and today we are going to go through the steps on processing Saturn. You can follow these steps and download the Saturn file in the comment section below. Also, I have a special guest announcement at the end of today's video. Come on, let's get started with processing Saturn.
Okay, so the first thing we need to do to help our video processing steps is to crop the image we have here, and there's a software you can use called Castrator. It's a video cropping software. You can download it. I'll put a download link for it in the comment sections below. It's a free software, but if you would, please go ahead and donate to the author. He's asking for a small donation. When you open up the software, it's pretty easy and straightforward to do. Basically, you open your data file, and in this case, we're working on Saturn. I'll open that. And when it gets done cropping the video footage, we'll just have this one little small square just around the image, and it's very easy to do. After you open it, you just say Process AVIs. And you'll notice that it's going through its steps, and when it gets done, it will then put a second file in the same folder. It's almost done. It's done now. Take a look here, and now we see there's a second file called Saturn_caster.avi. So now we can bring this file into our next processing step. The software we're going to use is called Registax. And the software is pretty easy to use. It kind of guides you through what you need to do by highlights on it. So the first thing we're going to do is select. So I'm going to select the Saturn Caster. This is the cropped version we did in the Castrator software. We open that up. You can pretty much just click the defaults on most of these items. I mean, if you want to get around, start playing around with these, you can to really nail in your desired results, but just click set points and put a couple of set points there. You can click align, goes through it very quickly when it's cropped like this, then limit. And what I'm going to do is, the image is kind of small, so if you do a drizzle, and I'm doing about a 0.5, but if you use a larger number, it'll make the image a little bit larger. So I'm going to do that, and then also I'm going to use this, show the stack graph, and in the stack graph what I'll do is I'll tell it to only stack images of that are about 250 of them here. I guess the further you go down on this bar here, these are the best of the images, so I'm gonna get a nice median of all the images, which is about 240. And then what I'll do is I'll just hit stack. And there we go, we've got the image. We used drizzle, and the drizzle brought the image a little bit larger. It's still kind of out of focus a little bit, but when you use the wavelet on here, the wavelet is really what brings everything together, and you start to see some of the detail. You could use the default or the Gaussian wavelet. Just kind of play around, see which works best with your image. But if you notice, as I start to click these values over here and slide to the right here, the image starts to get more detail on here. You can actually see a lot more detail on here. And just kind of have to play around with it a little bit until you get to an area that you like. Oh, and one thing that you can do, let's say that you pull out one really too far and it gets kind of wacky. If you just right-click on that bar, it'll just go back to the default, which is kind of handy to have. Just click, right click, and you can get back to the default as you start playing around with these different sliders here. So once you get something that's what you would like, then what you do is, I like to use the Rgb Align, and in my case I'm using a color webcam on here. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to tell it to align the Rgb channels. And when you do that, just click the Estimate button. And what it will do, it'll take a little bit of time, but it'll come back and it'll align the RGB channels up for you. And that looks pretty good. We'll go ahead and you get ready to complete your image. You click this Do All button, and it'll do the entire image. And then what you want to do is you want to save the image. So we'll just hit click Save. Okay, so we're going to do some post-processing on Saturn after we've taken it out of Registax. First thing I want to do is I want to sharpen the image up just a little bit. Whenever I do my Photoshop routines, I always like to start off with an original so I can see how much I've progressed as I do each step. So I'm going to drag it down here, make a copy of it. And what I'll do here is I'll go to Filter, Other, High Pass. And you'll play around with the high pass filter a little bit. I found that 4.5 seems to work pretty well. Try something that fits your taste. I just want to bring a little bit of the details out. I'll say OK. Now you're looking at it right now thinking, wow, that's a great sharpening maneuver there, Doug. Well, the next step you do is you just take this layer, instead of making it normal, change that to a soft light, and you can see it brings out a little bit of a detail on there, before and after on there. So next step I'm going to do is I'm going to merge that down, flatten it down, and I'm going to do a step of match color here. And the way you do that is you do image, adjustments, match color, and I'm gonna bump up the color intensity. I really like this orange band that's starting to appear right here. You know what, I'm just gonna bump it up all the way just to get that orange band, but you notice that there's some undesirable results right here with this bluish green right here, but I think I'll do a layer mask on that. So I'll say okay, and then I'll do layer mask, hide all. And what I'll do next is I'll grab the paintbrush tool, and it's white right now on a black canvas here, and I'm going to just kind of like paint the area that I like. So you can see how that orange band that I was pointing at earlier is now becoming a better color, in my opinion. Let's just do a little bit more color enhancement here. Okay, now that that step's done, I'm going to merge that down onto another one. So I'll say merge down. And I think what I'm going to do now is this area right here, it looks kind of bad. It looks like it's, I don't know, some kind of, something got lost in the optics there. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to clean that up a little bit. I know it's not the best thing to clone a brush, but I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to select the clone brush. Hold the Alt key down to select an area I want to clone, and then I'm just going to start kind of like painting that in a little bit. Cloning it off. Okay, that looks pretty good like that. I like that better than it did before. Here's the before and then after. Just cleaned it up a little bit by doing that. So that pretty much wraps up the image here. Taking a look at what we originally started with, this is what we had before when we had our video. I mean, going through these steps, we've come a long way from going from something like this now to something that looks like this. So those are some pretty impressive results. Maybe the only other thing I might suggest here is to maybe take the image and let's try rotating it a little bit. Let's say image rotation. Let's try that. That looks pretty good. Sometimes you flip the image around. I'm really not into the precise mechanics of it. Whatever the image looks good to me, that's how I like it. Yeah, I'm not trying to depict north or south on it. So that pretty much wraps it up. And then when you get ready to save your image to share, you go to File and Save for Web. And when you do that, then you can export it out to a JPG file and share it with everyone on the internet.
If this is your first time watching, I'd like you to subscribe to my channel. I publish 2 astrophotography videos on the 1st and 15th of every month. In my next video, I'll have a special guest, Houston Haynes. He will lead part 4 with processing a solar image. Houston is an avid solar photographer with many helpful hints on his YouTube channel. He will use the same solar data I've shared with you and go through his solar processing steps. Please visit Houston's YouTube channel and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you soon.